Hey everyone, it's Dylan from the Black Forest Wood Company. This week we're going to be introducing a brand new product to you guys that we're releasing. It's our graphene coating. So this is going to be in addition to our ceramic line of products that we already offer. The graphene is actually a step up from the base coat that we already sell, so it's going to give more abrasion resistance, more water resistance, more chemical resistance. It goes on a little bit quicker. There's more finesse involved with it, but we're going to show you guys and demonstrate how it's used today. And we'll have links below in the description if you guys do want to purchase this. But I hope you enjoy this tutorial, and please leave any of your questions below. So we typically will put our ceramic coatings most commonly over an oil-based finish, but it can be used over many different kinds of finishes. So this desk here today that I'm going to put the graphene on is actually finished with polyurethane, and it's going to work just as good as the oil-based finishes. To take it even a step farther, you know, these products can be used on plastics, metal, glass, all different kinds of things to get that added protection. So first step that's really important is just to clean your piece and make sure there's no dust. So I've just got a spritzer with some water, a microfiber cloth, give it a light spritz, and I'm just going to clean this desk off before we start. You can see we're picking up lots of dust off there. You definitely don't want that on there before you put your coating on. So we have our desk completely cleaned off. Again, I just use water. If you do have like any harsh stains on there, like anything sticky like that, you may want to use isopropyl alcohol diluted in water. That would be completely safe on a polyurethane table. However, if the piece has oil and wax, you need to be really careful using isopropyl alcohol because you can break down the finish that's already on there. But with this polyurethane, it's actually rated up all the way against sulfuric acid, so we can put pretty much whatever we want on this surface. Now, one thing with polyurethane I'll mention, it's not as easy to maintain as an oil-based finish, and typically it's something that a professional needs to be hired for to spray on. You can keep it looking fresh with the graphene or the ceramic, but any scratches you get, like I see there's a scratch here, a little bit of one here, and then there's another dent here. So we got the dent and the scratch. To fix those, you'd pretty much be sanding this thing all the way back down to raw wood over the whole surface, whereas with an oil finish, you could just touch up those sections and do spot repairs. So that's one difference to be aware of. When it comes to actually applying the graphene, the tools you're going to need are the exact same as the ceramic. So if you've used the ceramic before, you should already have these. You'll have your applicator block, and then you'll have the blue applicator pads. You will also want to have another clean microfiber ready to go. So I just like to fold them into four so you can get a nice flat surface there to work with. Have that ready to go on the side. Have your graphene ready to go. Apply it to the pad. First thing you'll see is it's very dark in color. That's the actual graphene that's in there. So then I'm going to have my applicator in one hand, my microfiber to buff off in the other, and you're gonna see what I mean about instantly buffing it off. I'm working very, very quickly here. And the biggest difference with our graphene between the ceramic when it comes to application is this is going to set up and cure a lot quicker, and you almost have to instantly buff it off. Whereas with the ceramic, you could do a larger section and then come back and buff it off. So this has to be buffed off very quickly, but you do get the benefits of increased durability, so you're gonna get more scratch and abrasion resistance. And one of the biggest benefits to the graphene is it's gonna increase chemical and liquid resistances even more than the ceramic would. So it's gonna be very hard to stain this surface once you've applied the graphene on. The graphene does have a high solid content in it, so you're going to want to make sure that you mix it up thoroughly before you're applying it to your block. So even though this product, I guess it's easier to potentially mess up because it cures quicker, in general it's overall just an easier product to apply. It's way, way quicker. You don't have to buff off nearly as much as you do with the ceramic, and the protection is superior. So there's a lot of reasons to want to go with this graphene over the ceramic. One thing to consider though, it is about 15% more expensive than ceramic. So if you want to save money and still get a good finish, go with our regular ceramic coating. But for those people who just want the absolute best finish and they're willing to pay a bit more, this is what you want. So on this final section, we're going to do a little test for you guys, and I'm just going to continue to apply this until I feel like it's at a point where it would be too cured, or it's starting to cure too much, and if you went any farther, you'd run into issues. So that'll give you an idea how quick you got to work with this. So there's probably about twice as much resistance now as to when I started, and I can feel it now starting to dry. So I want to buff that off. So that was what, like 15 seconds, maybe 20 seconds. We'll put a timer on the screen so we can figure that out. But it's not very long at all that you have with this stuff. But again, very easy. I'm done that table, and it probably took us about 10 minutes or so, I would say. So one thing I'm noticing too now is that my cloth is just very slick. You guys can see that it's like sliding across the table. The graphene really relieves a lot of the friction that you feel. So once this is dry, it's just got a lot nicer tactile feel. It's very smooth, very slick. Okay, so that's first coat done. We're gonna leave this for 30 minutes to set up a little bit. Then we can come back, do another coat of the graphene, then we'll wait another 30 minutes, and we'll come back and do a coat of the top coat, and then this desk will be completely protected. Okay, so it's actually been a little bit over half an hour, probably closer to 1 or 2 hours that we've waited since the last coat. Like I mentioned previously, all that you need to wait is 30 minutes, but that also doesn't mean that it's ready for use after 30 minutes. It's only ready for a recoat. Charlie just wanted to be a part of this. So yeah, it's only for a recoat after 30 minutes that it's safe to do. But again, I'm probably not going to use this piece until tomorrow morning once it's had at least overnight to cure. But this second coat, I'm going to follow the exact same process as I did for the first coat. The only thing that you might notice different here is you'll probably need to use a little bit less product, and your pad should glide a little bit easier over as well. So one thing that I find is when it comes to the second coat, it's a little bit more forgiving, since there already is that layer of graphene on there, and it just tends to be a more slick surface. So I'm actually kind of able to get away with some larger areas than I would usually do if this was the first coat. Like the size of the area I'm doing right now is more comparable to what you would see us do with our ceramic. But as long as you're quick, you can get away with this. So now that we finished our second coat, we're gonna wait another 30 minutes and then we're gonna come back and apply the top coat. All right, so it's been about half an hour and I want you guys to take a look at the pad that we used for the graphene. You can obviously see that there was graphene in there. A lot of solid content, and it'll actually turn your pads black. So I'm not going to use this one again for the top coat. Just going to set that aside. And I've got a fresh pad here that I'll wrap around. And now that I'm on to the ceramic top coat, I can do even larger areas than I was doing before. This has a longer open time. There we are. This has a longer open time than the graphene. So it's a lot more forgiving. Again, you can do larger areas. And kind of the difference between the top coat and the base coat, or even the top coat and the graphene, is that this is a little bit of a softer coating. And what that actually does is protects the harder coating underneath. So that may not make a lot of sense. It may sound counterintuitive, but any damage or abrasions that happen are only happening to the top coat, which is very malleable, very easy to polish and buff out. So if you do get a mark, you know, you can put some more top coat on, buff it in, and it will likely go away. Whereas if you skip this, you would be damaging your base coat, which is harder and not quite as easy to repair. So that's why we really like to use this top coat. So not only am I doing a larger surface area this time, but I'm actually able to spend a longer amount of time working it in and buffing it in, because it doesn't set up quite as quickly. So I've done about 3 passes over this now. I'm confident I've got it covered everywhere. Now I'll just take that microfiber and buff off the excess, same as we did with the graphene. So now we've done 2 coats of graphene and 1 coat of our top coat. You could go ahead and do another coat of top coat if you really wanted to, but we usually just save that as a maintenance step. So after a few months, you know, if you're noticing that you think you've got a few marks on it or there's some imperfections, you can go ahead and put that fresh coat of top coat on to make it look good again. And so long as you don't severely damage this and like scratch through the finish, you should just be able to maintain your piece with that top coat. Now for an oil and wax based table, over time, you know, you might need to do another coat of oil. So if you already have graphene or ceramic on there and you have an oil and wax based table, I would just use a gray Scotch-Brite pad that does have abrasive to it. So you can do that on the surface. That'll remove your coating. You can put a fresh coat of oil on. allow that to cure for about a week, and then repeat this process that we just showed with the graphene. So again, lots of uses for this. You can use it on your furniture, steel. One thing that we've heard it used for is on appliances, because you don't get as many fingerprints and they're a lot easier to clean off. So let us know if you guys have tried our product and used it on something different before. But thank you for watching this, and please as well leave any comments below if you have any questions. We'll do our best to get back to them. And actually, probably before the end of this video, tomorrow we'll film a clip and show you how hydrophobic this surface is now, and just what our results were. So another thing that you guys are probably going to notice, if you haven't already, is that this table has a few issues on it. One being that the live edge is starting to separate away from the epoxy, and there's some large air bubbles in it. So we know why this happened. This was one of the first resin tables that we ever made, and we used a technique that we never use anymore, and that is sealing the live edges. And we also, this was the first brand of epoxy we'd ever tried. Charlie wants some star time here. So it was the first brand of epoxy we ever tried, and it had a tendency to kind of overheat and get quite warm during the cure cycle. So by it overheating and it curing quite quickly, that's what caused those bubbles. And by us sealing the live edge before we did our pour, that's what's causing it to delaminate. So this table is about 5 years old, so it has been around for a while. But after 5 years, you can see it is coming apart. I don't think this would ever fully separate, but it does give you some insight on how a sealed edge will hold up long term. Okay, so it is the next day now. It's been about 24 hours since we did our coatings on this. Again, to recap, we did 3 coats, 2 graphene and 1 top coat. And as you guys can see, I'm already able to put all my stuff back on the desk and use it again. So it's got that layer of protection, and like with the tactile difference, you can notice it's a lot more slick. Like my hands just glide across a lot easier, like especially when compared to this table that doesn't have it. Not so much. So we can kind of demonstrate this by sliding a water bottle across. So on this table, that's about how far the water bottle goes. Doesn't really slide that easily. Whereas on the one with the graphene, you can see it slides a lot farther with a lot less resistance on there. So it feels a lot nicer, and it also makes the surface a lot easier to clean because nothing's going to really stick to this surface. Another thing that it does that I haven't mentioned yet is it actually makes it anti-static, which is a good thing if you have an epoxy table, because for whatever reason, epoxy tends to generate a lot of static electricity and dust can tend to collect on it. So if you've applied the graphene, you're not going to have as much of that issue. The other thing that it does is it makes the surface quite hydrophobic. So I'll just pour a little bit of water on here, or a lot of water. And you can see when I move it around, it kind of wants to form into these thin beads. And it glides across again very easily. It just goes right over the surface and forms nice little droplets or these thin little beads. And then it also is very easy to clean up. So we'll just use that microfiber. Yeah, so there you go. It comes off very easily. And then again, when compared to, let's say, this table that doesn't have anything on it, we'll pour a little bit of water. You can see it doesn't really bead up the same. It kind of lies more flat on this surface, and it actually begins to soak into the wood. So that's where you can get water spots created, is when the liquid isn't beading off the surface, then it's going to get into those pores. And when I do go to clean this, you can see it's kind of just rubbing it into the wood more so. And now I've got a really large damp section here, and I can actually feel that the wood itself is damp. So big advantages liquid wise to putting that on. We will have it on our website. We'll put a link below. Right now you guys are able to order the graphene bottles on their own, but very shortly we're going to offer it as a kit as well, where you can get the graphene with the top coat there. So please, if you guys like this and you want to try it, go purchase it. Let us know what you think. And we really, really appreciate all the support. You know, our ceramic product especially, we've been blown away at the response with that. So many people have been buying it. Everyone seems to love it. So we cannot thank you guys enough. And again, if you have any questions, leave them below and we'll be happy to answer. But we will see you guys next week. Another thing I should mention is we actually do have a sale going on right now in our business, and we have a new product that we're offering. So the new product is our Black Forest Metallic Pigments. We'll also leave a link for those below. We've got 15-gram jars and 5-gram sample size packs that you can also order as like a whole kit if you want to get one of every color. Then we have our, and those are going to be 15% off. Then we have our exotic woods on special right now in store. Those are 25% off. If you guys did want a larger order that was shipped, you can call the store and we can get a quote for that. And then we also have our oval forms that are 40% off. So those can be ordered online. So again, we'll leave a link in the description below. You guys can check that out. And again, thank you for choosing to shop with us.